The guys join Ric Garni now to break it all down.
All right, a busy week in pub politics nation. Wes Donehue on the Republican side, Phil Bailey, constant on the Democratic side. Phil cannot be muzzled on pub politics. That is one thing we do know.
Or on Twitter.
No, he has been muzzled on Twitter.
Oh, true. I have been muzzled on Twitter.
That's a shame.
I want to. We'll clear the air here. Right off the bat here in pub politics, Phil was involved in what I was calling Tweetgate last week, when you made the Nikki Haley seek Jesus comment, talking about her appearance at a hearing, GOP candidates trying to get back on the ballot. Oh, look, we have it through the magic of television.
Wonderful.
Now, Phil, there was a huge firestorm created about this, so I want to go ahead and give you a chance to say what's on your mind. Tell me how this all came about. Do you regret posting the tweet? And what have you heard, and what is going on now since this happened the past couple of days?
I'm just going to keep it real simple. It was an off-color joke, and it was a poor attempt at humor, and I'm sorry for that.
Now, Wes, you came out and didn't necessarily defend what he said, but you kind of made an issue about all the craziness that enveloped him after it all happened.
Yeah, I think it was kind of a manufactured controversy. Obviously, it was an off-collar joke. He apologized, and I think it should have been dead after that. But listen, Phil's a political operative who takes shots at people, so when they get the opportunity, they're going to take those shots back. I thought it was uncalled for. I thought it was kind of immature on their part, but it's a dead issue. It was a joke, and it just needs to be kept as a joke.
Now, has anything happened? I know Senator Hutto said that you were officially reprimanded. I mean, is there anything, have you had anything taken away from you as far as your role with the Democratic Party, or is everything still?
Yeah, I went to work the next day. I continue to go to work and do the best job I can for the Senate Democratic Caucus.
And will Phil Bailey SC, the Twitter account, will we see that again anytime soon? Has there been a decision made on that?
We shall see.
All right, so to be announced, to be determined, I guess we should say. You know, there was some other news on the pub politics front, because last week the Jake Knotts, infamous Jake Knotts video surfaced. Now, this is almost 2 years old. And, you know, we knew what happened at the time. That's when Senator Knotts made his raghead comment about Governor Haley, President Obama. So there wasn't really any news here as far as what was said, because we knew what was said. He didn't deny it back at the time, but we never really saw any audio or video after the fact. You had said that you have the one copy under lock and key, but lo and behold, the website BuzzFeed gets a hold of it, and there's Jake Knotts, there's you, there's Phil, I think, was it Boyd Brown was sitting there?
Yeah, a couple others.
Yeah, so there it was, the video. So my question to you, Wes, is this, how did this video get out, or did somebody actually record it at the time off the website and just keep it until now?
Yeah, they kept it. It'll be 2 years next week. This was not the copy that I had under lock and key. It actually had the Ustream logo. It had ads popping up on the video, which means they actually recorded it while it was happening live. I guess pub politics was just so popular that people are recording it live now. Like almost like DVR or something.
But if I remember right, wasn't Senator Knotts an unannounced guest?
Yeah, that's what was so weird about it. Yeah. We literally were during the show. We were drinking beers. We saw him walk up in the parking lot and said, "Oh my God, is Senator Knotts coming on the show?" We were kind of excited because we expected him to say some crazy things. Not that crazy, but it's kind of weird that it came out this long.
Yeah, and whoever had this video that gave it to BuzzFeed, obviously there was some kind of ulterior motive, because it is an election year. Senator Knotts, we thought it was going to be facing Katrina Sheely in the primary. It doesn't look like that's going to happen. But still, it is an election year for Jake Knotts, and the timing, I don't want to say is coincidental, because it probably isn't.
It's certainly not coincidental. Yeah. The timing of the video gets leaked out to the press the day before the state Republican Party Executive Committee was meeting to whether or not to recertify or certify candidates, and Katrina Sheely was one of those people to run against Jake Knotts. So, I mean, the timing is certainly not coincidental.
But would this actually hurt Senator Knotts? Because this is, I mean, it's almost been 2 years, but it's nothing new. We knew these comments happened almost 2 years ago.
Yeah, it's not good, though. It reminded people. Okay. And there's also a big difference in hearing that someone said it than actually seeing them say it, especially when you're there at the bar. So, yeah, I think this could hurt Senator Knotts, and I think Phil's right. I think this was something that was coordinated.
Now, the GOP did have the hearing for a couple of candidates, and Katrina Sheely, who would challenge Jake Knotts in a primary, was one of those. GOP actually said that we want her back on the ballot, but the State Election Commission said, no, we can't do it that way. Just your thoughts on how that all turned out.
It's a big mess. I mean, I can't really say much except that. I mean, the whole entire thing has just been a complete cluster, and I don't really know what else to say.
What were your thoughts, Phil, on Governor Haley appearing? She said it was just because she wanted to defend the process. The other side is saying, well, she showed up just for, you know, one of her pals, Katrina Sheely.
Yeah, she showed up for her her crony, Katrina Sheely, who happened to be the only candidate that the state Republican Executive Committee recertified. And it was in direct conflict with an order from the South Carolina Supreme Court. I was just amazed that Queen Nikki Haley could just sit there and make a decree to ignore the ruling of the Supreme Court.
Wes, did you buy her argument that she was just trying to to support the process and not just one particular candidate?
I don't know, man. I want to defend the governor on this one. I really do, but it just kind of muddied what was already muddied. I mean, it's just been so confusing that whenever the SCGOP made this move, it just made things even a bigger mess.
All right, so pubpoliticslive.com is the website to catch these guys. We'll put the Twitter accounts up for you guys. Phil's, hopefully we'll be back soon, but we'll see you on that. Guys, once again, thanks for coming by.
Thank you.
All right, back to you.
Thanks, guys. Well, you can follow all the political news leading up to the June 12th primary by